Punch your ticket to the Spurs, the Cowboys, and all around the great Lone Star State. It's the Ticket Live.
You want to say, I'm Cam for the Ticket Live, and we'll see you later. Go ahead and say that. Say into the camera, say, I'm Cam for the Ticket Live, and we'll see you later.
Cam and Clive, see you later.
Might as well open the show with a good friend we met while covering the Rangers and defending American League champion Indians in Arizona last weekend. Welcome to the Ticket Live Big League Weekend Special presented by Halftime Pizza. Yes, a special hour to get you ready for the coming HEB Big League Weekend set for this Friday and Saturday. The specifics of the games, all the events surrounding the contest, just part of what we've got in store. It's a show worthy of a Hall of Famer. As in Pudge Rodriguez, the former Ranger star, surprised us while we were in Surprise, Arizona. Has his recent Hall of Fame selection hit him yet? If you're thinking, you know, I was busy with football, the Spurs are now doing their thing, I didn't follow the baseball offseason like I would have liked to, we got you covered. Take you through the key subtractions and additions for both franchises. As Ranger fans well know, one guy makes the key additions list for one club and the key departures list for the other. We heard from the players and the managers, including several in-depth conversations, got all the angles. But while this is a special edition of the Ticket Live, one thing that won't change, how we start our 10 o'clock hour. The 10 at 10 is presented by AAA Garcia Bail Bonds, because speaking of 10, no one knows numbers better when you might find yourself in a bad spot, more so than AAA Garcia Bail Bonds. 24/7 with three locations, San Antonio, Hondo, and Kerrville. AAA Garcia Bail Bonds works hard to get your loved one out of jail, whether for traffic tickets, warrants, DUI, or any other type of violation. Offering free warrant checks, low-down payment plans, quick and discreet bail bonds, AAA Garcia, license number 195, is the presenting sponsor for the 10 at 10. More about AAA Garcia Bail Bonds later on in the show. Now, this morning's 10 at 10 focuses on the top 10 reasons Big League Weekend has enjoyed success in San Antonio. But we start off the list. Number 10, San Antonio organizations, officials, and businesses have come together. It's been a total team effort, from Ryan Sanders baseball to city leaders to great sponsors. Number 9, helps get the major league season going. That happens right before the season starts in early April. Number 8, chance to do the 7th inning stretch, big league style. It just has a different feel to it. Number 7, the cool festivities. We'll get to everything that happens throughout the weekend later in the show. Number 6, the Alamo Dome. Yeah, wacky configuration. It's pretty much become a draw for fans and for the players, as you heard later on. Number 5, SA's chance to watch professional athletes. Yep, at the highest level outside of the Spurs. Number 4, Texas Rangers. Don't have to tell you, they got a big fan base here. Number 3, Ryan Sanders baseball. Later in the show, we're going to hear from them on how they've managed to do this. Number 2, turned into a tradition, but it's also stayed fresh. Those specifics in just a minute. And the number one reason Big League Weekend has become a success here in San Antonio, SA loves sports. We are a great sports town. I'm gonna expound on that at the end of the show. Now, with the game scheduled for Friday at 7 and Saturday at 2, a lot of you know plenty about the Rangers, and we'll get to them in a little bit. But for now, how about a profile of the defending AL champs as they get set to make their first trip to San Antonio? Their key additions and subtractions during the offseason coming up. No doubt about their biggest pickup. That has got to be Enwin Encarnacion. The slugger comes over from Toronto, and some have said he could be the difference for a club that was up 3-1 in the World Series. Boone Logan, the local guy, much more with him later. A big lefty that Cleveland can now throw out there in different situations. Tribe also picked up Austin Jackson, Chris Colabello, Willie Mopeña, and Carlos Frias. As for the losses, Mike Napoli, the aforementioned guy who makes both lists. Rajai Davis, who hit the big homer in the World Series Game 7 rally that ultimately fell short. Coco Crisp. Jeff Manship, another local guy, the former Reagan Rattler, no longer in Cleveland. No are Austin Adams or Jesus Aguilar. So while the Tribe get ready for their first taste of HEB Big League Weekend, it's been 5 years, can you believe it? 5 years since South and Central Texas fans got their first taste of Major League ball in San Antonio. Let's go by the numbers, courtesy of Superior Tax Service, because the Indians are the 5th team the Rangers will play at the Alamo Dome. Superior Tax Service wants to thank you, our viewers and our listeners, for helping them grow, because Superior Tax Service has opened a new location, 4631 Vance Jackson. That phone number again is 224-5000, and the address, once again, 4631 Vance Jackson. Affordable tax preparation with a personal touch. Visit their website at superiortax.biz. Superior Tax Service with the pros. Get to know you to make tax time easier. As we look at the numbers and through the history of Big League Weekend, interesting that in every single year, the same team won both games on that given weekend. It all started in 2013 when the Mission's parent club, the Padres, agreed to play two against the Rangers. Texas won both 5-0 and 5-2 that year. The next season, baseball's Lone Star rivalry came to town. The Astros got the sweep 6-5 and 13-6. 2015 saw an old San Antonio favorite play their first ever games at the Alamo Dome. The Dodgers scored 11 runs in both contests, winning 11-6 and 11-3. And last year, it was the defending World Series champion Royals who made the trip. But for that weekend, the Rangers were the HEB Big League Weekend champs by scores of 7-5 and 13-6. As for the attendance through these first 4 years, how about an average of more than 60,000 fans per weekend? More on the history of Big League Weekend, including what lies ahead, coming up later in the show, because we are just getting started right here on the Big League Weekend special. Got tons to cover. Much more to come, including. What caused that look of amazement on the face of new Indian star Edwin Encarnacion? And later, he's the big leaguer coming home for Big League Weekend. We chat with former O'Connor pitcher Boone Logan. Those of you who knew him then or have met him along the way will recognize he's the exact same guy. We go one-on-one with a man who makes the final decisions when it comes to the Rangers. He's not even 40 yet, and he's been running the ball club for more than a decade. Speaking of the Rangers, we'll hear from pitcher Jake Diekman, who's living with a condition that led to the removal of his entire colon. While he's nowhere near being able to play again, still very much a part of the team, a big one too. And up next, we continue to set the table for next weekend. What the managers say about who's going to be here, it's a tough task for those guys to try to figure out who's going to make the trip to San Antonio, because they've got spring training games back in Arizona. They've got the dome games here for Big League Weekend. And then, oh, by the way, they've got the World Baseball Classic going on all at the same time. So players from both rosters making the trip here, staying in Arizona, or traveling around the country to play for their respective countries. So a tough task, but the managers finding a way to get players here and quality players at that. This is the Ticket Live Big League Weekend Special presented by Halftime Pizza.
The Ticket Live.
Welcome back to the Ticket Live Big League Weekend Special presented by Halftime Pizza. Because like Big League Weekend, Halftime Pizza is in a league of their own with two locations. Our longtime friends are growing. The new location is at 7531 Bandera. The original location is still at 7126 Tuzzle Road. Check out their website at halftimepizzasatx.com. And when you stop in, big screens, a bar, and family friendly. They open at 11 a.m. on Saturdays. So perfect, because that's when this show ends. Halftime Pizza, eat more pizza. You know, when it comes to this year's HEB Big League Weekend, one of the questions I get the most is, do you know which players are making the trip to San Antonio? Unfortunately, no, because the teams probably don't know yet. Keep this in mind. Both the Rangers and the Indians have Cactus League games scheduled in Arizona that same weekend. So Texas's Jeff Banister and Cleveland's Terry Francona have to figure out which players are staying in the Grand Canyon State, which players are coming here. Not to mention the guys that are playing in the World Baseball Classic right now. Both managers said they'll figure all this stuff out a couple of days before the games. Let's hear first from Banister, then from Tito, on the process that goes into who comes to San Antonio.
That's a bit of a challenge this year with the WBC, and really in the past it's been we kind of try to divide the camp up, where we have appropriate major league players who are going to arrive in San Antonio and represent the Texas Rangers and give the fans major league players to see. There's still an evaluation process. Some of the guys that go may not be in a situation where they are actually fighting for a job. Plus, that process is what staff members and who are going to watch these guys. Even though we still have video, it's plus there's some young guys that we want to see, and hopefully large crowds, to see how they respond to that extra deck on a stadium, the lights, and it seems a little more real. see how they compete. So a multitude of reasons.
We've started doing some checking with guys because, again, we have 4 games in 2 days, and we want to split it up so no fans get shortchanged if we can help it. So if there's guys that want to go, I mean, that's kind of seems like an easy one. So that's what we're trying to check with first, you know, like you say, family, or if there's a reason guys want to go, we just want to find out. So then we'll go.
Every reason to believe both Francona and Banderson when they say we'll see legitimate big league talent here next weekend. Both have talented roster to choose from, after all. Now, we ran down the Indians' new faces a little while ago. For the Rangers, you know their fixtures. Adrian Beltre, Elvis Andrews, Yu Darvish. But let's go over some of their new guys. Or in the case of Mike Napoli, old is new again, now in his third stint with Texas. Meanwhile, don't expect to see Andrew Cashner nor Tyson Ross at the Alamo Dome, at least not pitching. Ross will begin the season on the disabled list as he recovers from surgery. And a team shut down Cashner on Friday for recurring bicep soreness. They say he may not be ready for the start of the regular season. Now, acquiring those guys, even as they battle through injuries, is the work of one John Daniels, a native of Queens, New York, that is. The Cornell grad has made himself a Texas baseball fixture over the last decade plus, becoming the youngest general manager in Major League history at the age of 28 and then qualifying for 2 World Series within 6 years is going to accomplish that. We went one-on-one with John Daniels in Arizona.
Well, John, what is this time of the year like for you? Because you spend the offseason tinkering, assessing, putting the team together. And then in less than a month, it's going to get going for real. But in the meantime, you finally get a chance to see the new pieces kind of come together with what you already have. So what's this like this time of the year like for you?
It's a lot of fun, honestly. It's team building in the sense that we're trying to get the guys that are going to be out there at 7:05 on opening day out together.
Yes.
and make decisions on
what?
The team. But it's a lot of team building from an organization standpoint. The big league coaching staff, the front office, our scouts, our minor league coaches, our trainers, strength coaches on down the line. And it's really the one time a year we're all together. And so there's a lot of exchange of ideas, a lot of personal time, take different guys out to dinner. And I really think this is spring training's like a jumping off point for the whole organization.
Got to ask this, and I hope this isn't too personal, but considering how young you are and how long you've been doing this, you ever kind of sit back and think, you're 38, am I 39, right?
Yeah.
39. Do you sit back and think, I'm 39 and I've been doing this for darn near 15 years? I mean, does that ever kind of hit you? I know you're so busy with the task at hand, but does that ever cross your mind?
Well, I turned 40 this summer, so I've had a lot of guys remind me of that. It's made me think about it a little bit. I'm actually going to be, first time I'll be a real age for a grown man. So I've been incredibly fortunate. You know, I work with a lot of good people, continue to work with great people, and I think that's why we've had success. It's like we've had so many good people here over the years. A lot of them are still here. Others have moved on. But it takes so many people to make it happen that, you know, I joke, I'm just a pretty face in the front. Not that pretty, but I'm in the front anyway. So, just real fortunate to be part of it.
This particular spring training, how much of a challenge is the balance between, I mean, you're the GM and the president of baseball operations for the Rangers. At the same time, you know your guys put a lot of stock into representing their home countries. How tough is that balance for you?
Yeah, you know, there's a little part that, you know, you want to wrap your arms around, put bubble wrap around them and not let them out of the nest, right? But I love the WBC. I think it's a great tournament. I think it's fun baseball to watch. And I encourage our guys to play. My only concern is, you know, if guys aren't going to play, you know, and they're not going to get the reps they need to be ready. That's a concern. And obviously the injury risk, because, you know, people can get hurt anywhere.
And obviously we got the trip to San Antonio coming up. Just from a Rangers perspective, what that trip means to your organization to be able to play some ball, albeit in unique circumstances at the Dome, but still to be able to play some ball in front of San Antonio fans.
It's cool, man. It's a one-of-a-kind opportunity to play there in that market, and also the way that the field's been configured. Our guys have fun when they go out there. Obviously, you know, the short porch, and it's kind of a unique deal. You end up seeing a whole bunch of home runs, which are fun for the fans, but our guys like it. It's fun. Chance for them to get back to the state of Texas, family come down and see them, and we're looking forward to it.
Well, John, we appreciate the time. Thank you. Best of luck this season.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Still to come, the Ranger who's down but not out. How his teammates have made sure of that. There's a Ticket Live Big League in West Special, presented by Halftime Pizza.
The Ticket Live.
Pre-2012, the year it was announced that Big League Weekend would be coming to San Antonio, you know, like all the way back in 2011, what would you have said had someone told you, we're going to get major league teams to play two games in the Alamo Dome, and then we're going to do it every year for four more years? Along the way, you're going to get to see the Rangers play the Astros, you'll see the Dodgers, you'll see the defending World Series champion at one point, and you'll see a defending American League Series champion. The guy you're about to hear from has made all that a reality. We went one-on-one with Ryan Sanders' COO, J.J. Gotch.
Take me back seven, eight, maybe even longer, years back. The ideas kind of talked about, thrown back and forth about doing this unique Big League Weekend thing in San Antonio. Could you have envisioned that here we are again, however a number of years later, getting ready to do a fifth annual Big League Weekend in the Alamo Dome?
You know, going back to really 2012 when we really started having these discussions with the Rangers and officials from San Antonio, to say that, you know, in 2017 we'd be here in Goodyear, Arizona at Indian Spring Training Camp getting ready to embark on our fifth year, you know, no, I don't. Really, our thought was pretty basic and pretty simple. You know, our goal with Ryan Sanders Baseball has always been to bring the game of baseball to as many people as possible. Back in 2012, one of the initiatives with the Rangers was to try and increase their brand throughout the state of Texas, specifically San Antonio. And so really trying to match those two things up, create a unique event, is when we started talking to folks in San Antonio, really looking at the Alamo Dome as a possibility and bringing Major League Baseball to San Antonio, if not for the year, at least for a weekend. And doing it in a fun setting like the Dome and over spring training. And really our goals that first year, Hector, were just to try to get through that first year. We had an idea and a thought of how the event might go, but we really didn't go too far beyond that. And so we wanted to really put everything into that first year. And obviously that first year we had almost 75,000 fans, incredible success, and we knew that we had something on our hands there. And so ultimately we started to develop a little bit more of a long-term plan, start looking 2, 3, 4, 5 years in advance. And so to be where we are now, going into our fifth year, bringing as many people to the Alamo Dome, exposing the game of baseball to as many people as we've been able to with these Major League Exhibition games, giving the ability for the Rangers to continue to expose their brand to San Antonio fans. We're really proud of what we've been able to accomplish and work with all of our partners. City of San Antonio has been fantastic. Obviously, our partners with the Missions, allowing us to come into the San Antonio market and work with us. It's really been a great experience and something that I think we can all be proud of.
And I'm curious about this. 5 years in, when you look back, how weird, crazy were the looks you got when you said baseball and Alamo Dome in the same sentence?
You know, because not growing up in San Antonio, even though obviously the Alamo Dome was specifically not built for baseball, and we're promoters. We're always trying to do unique things and kind of think out of the box. And so it really wasn't until we really got deep into San Antonio and started talking to folks, and like, well, the whole reason that there's not baseball in San Antonio is because the Dome doesn't work. And we're like, well, we're gonna try to figure out a way to make it work. And obviously for 162 game full MLB season, probably it wouldn't work, but for these two games it does. And so I think that was a part of really the first year, people coming out and saying, wait, how is baseball even going to work in here? So the nostalgia, but then I think what we've been able to build over those 3, 4, 5 years with all the affordable family entertainment, post-game concerts, the fan fest, the sports collectible show, everything we've built around to where it's not just baseball, it's an event, I think has been able for us to sustain and go past that just 1 year nostalgia period.
From the Padres that first year, Astros, Dodgers, you know, Royals in there, now the Indians, I think you guys have done a fantastic job of keeping what's now become a tradition fresh at the same time.
And that's the thing, is because, again, if it was just two Major League spring training games in the Alamo Dome and that was it, it would be very tough for us to continue to sell every year and get people to come back to. But by bringing in top-level talent, you know, we've been very fortunate, obviously, with bringing the Padres the first year, the, you know, the affiliate of the Missions, the relationship with the Ryans and the Astros in year two, and then really the last 3 years with the Dodgers, a preeminent team that always has a chance to go deep in the playoffs. Last year being fortunate enough to have the defending World Series champion Royals coming in, and then this year obviously with the Indians being one game away from the World Series champion, I think bringing in that level of team, we've been very, very fortunate. You know, a lot of that is due to the relationship not only that the Ryan family has within baseball, but really the Rangers and us partnering with them, being able to have conversations with top level teams, and being able to really sell the city of San Antonio, sell the Alamo Dome, and the opportunity and the chance for them to come and play two games. And so for us, you know, all those things. It's not just one thing. It's a lot of things that have had to come together to really make this thing a success.
Talking with J.J. Gotch with Ryan Sanders Baseball, and because the level of success you guys have enjoyed these last 5 years, I'm wondering how often people in San Antonio and, heck, throughout South Texas come up to you guys and say, can you make it work permanently? What can we do, and what role can you guys play in making this something year-round in San Antonio?
You know, that's a question, Hector, not only do baseball fans in San Antonio ask, but, you know, where we spend most of our time in Austin, they ask that same question. And to say, is it a possibility? Absolutely. When you talk to officials with Major League Baseball and they talk about if expansion ever does become a possibility or if a team does come up for sale and there's a possibility for a relocation, I definitely think this Central South Texas, Austin, San Antonio market will be one that will be in the mix. Obviously, the relationships that we built in Central Texas with the Ryan family and the roots in baseball in the state of Texas, not just with the Astros and the Rangers, but if that were to be something that were ever to come fruition, yes, we'd obviously want to be a part of that. You know, is that going to happen? I don't know. You know, I think that there's definitely a possibility. A lot of things would have to happen. And I think it may just be a matter of time with the way that the region is growing. You know, you talk about the number of people that are literally moving to San Antonio and Austin every day and all those points in between, San Marcos, New Braunfels, Kyle, Buda, you know, that corridor is becoming to one to where obviously the Spurs have done a great job. But I think that at some point in time, it may not be within 5 years, but maybe 10, 15, 20 years, there's going to be an MLB team or an MLS team or possibly even an NFL. You know, I think the market is one, it's going to be big enough. I think you're going to have the support at all levels, and there's definitely going to be enough people.
Well, I congratulate you on not only the success that Big League Weekend has enjoyed, and obviously Ryan Sanders Baseball, the driving force behind that, but also for setting, if not a blueprint or a template, at least setting the foundation to letting people in San Antonio and Central Texas and South Texas know that, yes, this can happen and this can be good in San Antonio. So congrats on that, Jay.
No, absolutely, Hector. We really do appreciate it. And like I said, we've got a great core group of folks that work on this. But for something this size and something that only happens over a couple of days, you've got to have great partners. As I mentioned, working with the city of San Antonio, working with the folks at the Alamo Dome, our partners with the missions, and all of our corporate partners, obviously with HEB and Whataburger and all of our other friends in San Antonio, it's a group effort. And for us, again, it's a very simple goal. We want to bring the game of baseball to as many people as possible. And so this allows us to do that. And as long as we continue to do it and people keep coming to the games, we're going to keep planning it.
Later, we'll hear from JJ on all the festivities. Of course, they all center on the games. 7 o'clock start on Friday, 2 o'clock first pitch time on Saturday. Say about our legacy sponsor. Need home insurance? Jaime Elias has you covered. Need auto insurance? Jaime Elias has you covered. Need life insurance? Yep, Jaime Elias has you covered. For all your insurance needs, personal or business, only need to call Jaime, Farmers Agent, at 462-7250. He'll take care of the rest. This is the Ticket Live Big League Weekend Special presented by Halftime Pizza on KCWX TV and Ticket 760 AM.
The Ticket Live.
Welcome back to the Ticket Live Big League Weekend Special presented by Halftime Pizza. From the OC to the land, that's the nickname for Cleveland these days, right? Stops with the White Sox, Yankees, Rockies in between. Former O'Connor High School pitcher Boone Logan has spent the last 11 years pitching in the major leagues. A very special feat in of itself. It's what Boone wants to do when he's done that makes his journey even more endearing, especially to folks here.
Well, Boone, I remember vividly 06 in Arlington coming to chat with you because you were the local guy who had made the trip back to Texas, then with the Sox, obviously, mm-hmm. as a rookie, making the show. Mm-hmm. When you think about then as opposed to where you are now, does it seem like 20, 30 years ago as opposed to 11?
It's, you know, time does definitely fly, but it seems like I've been playing this game forever now. You know, baseball years like doggy years, it goes quick. You know, it's a short career, but it seems like I've been doing this for a good 20 years. But that was a long time ago. You know, 06, that was, when you put it that way, you know, that I have been playing for a little while. Yeah, I've come a long ways.
You're in the process, and especially right now during the exhibition season, it's all about getting better and what you're going to do this season. But when you do have a chance to think about, reflect on what's been a 10-year-plus major league career, you have to sit back and pinch yourself every once in a while? Do you think back to those O'Connor days? I mean, kind of what goes through your mind in those little moments when you do think about what you've been able to do in your career?
You know, I got to stay humble. I mean, I got to see that, you know, what I've done is something special that not a lot of us – I, you know, have the opportunity to do. And you know, it's been a great journey. You know, it's from the O'Connor days, you know, back when I signed in 02, 03, I think it was, I signed with the White Sox, to making my debut in 06. I mean, that was a long time ago. But, you know, time flies, and that just goes to show how fast time does fly in my mind. And, you know, when this career's over, you know, I'll be looking forward to getting back home and, you know, get back to reality and to the real world. You know, this is all fantasy world, and, you know, it's been a good ride, so I'm gonna ride it as long as I can and get home and live a normal, enjoyable life with my family.
Coach Colin Beck would kill me if I didn't, you know, ask about the O'Connor days and that San Antonio pride that you must still carry with you. How much of that 11 years into the bigs now is still with you? Is that one of those things that just never goes away, no matter how many years you're up here in the show?
Oh, I mean, you know, my hometown, Helotes, you know, is right outside San Antonio. But I represent San Antonio, Helotes, O'Connor. You know, I still go up to the high school at O'Connor and play catch and hang out with those guys before I come to spring training. So, you know, it means a lot to me. And whatever I can do to give back and help out the kids, I mean, that's really what it's about. That's what gets me fired up to get going in the season, is knowing that these kids are trying to, you know, achieve the same thing. And that puts things in perspective, you know, of, you know, I guess myself back in check a little bit to see how special it is of the, you know, being able to play Major League Baseball, but being with the kids and stuff, you know, it's just, you know, it's rewarding.
As a matter of fact, I think I saw Coach Colin Beck post a video, you and Mark Ecker throwing around, right? I mean,
he was always filming.
Yeah, just a couple of weeks ago, right, is what it was. Along those lines, do you kind of look at yourself as kind of a ambassador, might be the wrong word, but just kind of a spokesman for guys in the San Antonio area who can look at a Boone Logan and say, look at that. Why not me?
Yeah, you know, I've always been quiet when it comes to, you know, speaking, but it's flattering for sure. I mean, you know, I think I want to do more. You know, now I want to do more to give back. You know, even after baseball, like, I want to do more with the community and stuff. So, yeah, it's flattering to be looked at like that, you know, if I am. So, you know, it means a lot to me.
Speaking with Boone Logan, now Indians pitcher. Now, Boone, when you made the decision to come here to Cleveland, I know you kind of had to be a little patient, kind of look to see what else was going to fall, you know, in line throughout the offseason. But when it did come time to make your decision, and the defending AL champ is a team that's saying, hey, come play for us, and a guy like Terry Francona is coming, come play for me. What's that like for you?
An honor. Humbling. You know, to be able to have the opportunity to play, like I said earlier, for a team that's coming off of going to the World Series and one out away from getting there and winning it all, you know, and looking at what, you know, they want or need for the next season, and then, you know, getting a hold of me, it's big time. It's big. That's big. And like I said, I'm flattered to be able to be a part of it.
And even though the roster for who's making the trip to San Antonio might not be set, you're saying there's no doubt in your mind you're going to be part of the Indian squad that goes to San Antonio for Big League weekend.
Yeah, I mean, I'm saying absolutely. I still got to ask, but I'm sure it won't be a problem to be able to go home for a couple of days in my hometown, San Antonio, in Helotes.
Even if it's playing in the Alamo Dome in a configuration that I'm sure you're thinking is going to be out there.
It's spring training game. I mean, it could be 100 feet fences, and I'm fine with that.
But we're looking forward to seeing you at the Dome, and best of luck the rest of the way. Appreciate the
Thank
time.
You. Thank you very much.
Yep, the Ticket Live Big League Weekend Special presented by Halftime Pizza continues after this on KCWX TV and Ticket 760 AM.
The Ticket Live.
Talking with J.J. Gotch with Ryan Sanders Baseball. And J.J., I know you talked about it being an event. It's more than just two baseball games. While everything centers around those two ball games, you guys got concerts and a lot of different things going on for fans to be able to come out and see.
Exactly, and that's what we've always talked about, is we wanted to really create something beyond just the baseball, because it is spring training, and in a lot of years it has been a split squad. This year we've obviously got the World Baseball Classic, so rosters are even thinner. And so what we try to do is again, go out and get good quality teams that want to work with us and really primarily promote the game, but then provide a lot of other things. And so when folks come out before they even get to the gates of the Alamo Dome, you know, there's going to be a fan fest where there's going to be music going on. Nathan's is coming back with her hot dog eating competition again this year. Lots of fun. So before you even get inside the doors of the Alamo Dome, it's a great experience. This year we're giving away free Nolan Ryan baseball cards to the first 10,000 fans each day. So before you even get into the Dome, you've had a great experience. You get free cards. Once you get in, we've got the sports collectible show, which is a lot of different things. One for folks that are interested in a lot of rare and collectible memorabilia. We'll have a Babe Ruth baseball, a Lou Gehrig bat, all kinds of things like that. Folks, if you've got memorabilia, you can bring it in and actually find out how much it's worth. We're going to have great players there. Jose Cruz is going to be there both days signing autographs pregame for a lot of fans that grew up in San Antonio being Astros fans. I know they're excited about that. We've got the internet sensation Domingo Ayala there on Friday. He's going to be there meeting fans and taking pictures as well. And then, as you mentioned, after the games, it's been a lot of fun for us not to only provide music, but actually allow fans to come down onto the field after the games and do snow angels on the AstroTurf and run around the field. And we're excited this year. We've got Smash Mouth and Los Lonely Boys doing our post-game shows this year. So as you mentioned, baseball is obviously the main foundation of this weekend, but really we wanted to create an event, and all those things together have really done that.
Well, we heard from Ryan Sanders, COO, J.J. Gotts, earlier in the show about the genesis of Big League Weekend to where it is now and where it might go in the future. Talking just now, though, about all the events that go into making the weekend an event as opposed to just a couple of ball games. A lot to do for local fans. For more information, go to BigLeagueWeekend.com. As we near the end of the 10 o'clock hour, I want to remind you that our 10 at 10, top 10 reasons Big League Weekend has worked, was presented by AAA Garcia Bail Bonds. Because speaking of 10, no one knows numbers better when you might be in trouble more so than AAA Garcia Bail Bonds. 24/7 with three locations, San Antonio, Hondo, and Kerrville. AAA Garcia Bail Bonds works hard to get your loved one out of jail, whether for traffic tickets, warrants, DUI, or any other type of violation, offering free warrant checks, slowdown payment plans, quick and discreet bail bonds. AAA Garcia, license number 195, is a presenting sponsor for the 10 to 10. Say about what you can expect in tomorrow's Express News. Breaking news here, and the Express News will have more on it tomorrow. The Spurs have just announced that LaMarcus Aldridge is out indefinitely with minor heart arrhythmia. Out indefinitely. So we wish LaMarcus the best of luck, and we'll see what happens as the Spurs and LaMarcus undergo further tests. The paper is also going to do some coverage from the high school boys state basketball finals here at the Alamo Dome going on today. Time for our closing argument, courtesy of Thomas J. Henry. No one wishes to find themselves in tough times, but if you do, make Thomas J. Henry your first phone call. Available 24/7. Who do you need protecting you and your family? Fighting for injured victims is what they do best. So call Thomas J. Henry now. Injury attorneys available 24/7, nights and weekends, 656-1000. And now for today's closing argument related to Big League Weekend. You know, it's okay. In fact, you could say it's natural. With Major League Baseball teams set to play here next week, but just for the weekend, and with most of our pro teams either set to start soon or in season now, it's not uncommon at all to ask, why doesn't San Antonio, a top 10 city population-wise, have more actual pro teams? Well, yes, you've heard the many reasons, and you've heard them many times. We don't have the necessary number of Fortune 500s. We don't have the infrastructure. We won't show up for X number of time games, certain number of times a year for the home games. Other owners who are around here simply wouldn't allow it, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You and I, for the most part, can't control any of that. What we can control, though, is how we view our city. We are not small time. Small-time sports cities don't foster an environment that's allowed for the most successful sports franchise of the last 20 years. Small-time sports cities don't host four Final Fours in that same span. Small-time sports cities don't host a top college bowl game every year. Small-time sports cities don't create a culture where a college football program can make a mark as one of the fastest-growing, if not the fastest-growing program in the entire country. But step one in not being a small-time sports city is truly believing that we're not. There's an old saying that goes, treat someone as he is, and he's gonna remain as he is. Treat someone as he should be, and he'll become what he should be. There are several legitimate factors as to why more professional franchises haven't come to San Antonio. Don't let your mindset be one of those. Calvin Casey should be back in studio next weekend. Don't have to wait to then, though, to hear his takes. Calvin and the guys on the Sports Grind every afternoon, Monday through Friday, 2 to 4. Local sports with a national flair. I often get into those big time discussions as well as chat about what's going on around here. If you miss an episode, no worries. You can download the podcast at sportsgrindentertainment.com. Our closing argument is presented by Thomas J. Henry. No one better when you're in time of need. Thomas J. Henry, available 24/7. Who do you need protecting you and your family? Because fighting for injured victims is what they do best. Call Thomas J. Henry now. Injury attorneys available 24/7, nights and weekends, 656-1000. Again, that number is 656-1000. Not too late to get your tickets for the Rangers and the Indians. You can head to bigleagueweekend.com/tickets, or you can simply go to bigleagueweekend.com, check out the entire website, and while you're there, click on the link to the tickets. The defending American League West champs against the defending American League champs. One game on Friday at 7, one game on Saturday at 2. Our Ticket Live Big League Weekend special presented by Halftime Pizza. Like Big League Weekend, Halftime Pizza is in a league of their own with two locations. Our longtime friends are growing. The new location is at 7531 Bandera. The original location is still at 7126 Tesla Road. Check out their website, halftimepizzasatx.com. And when you stop in, big screens, a bar, and family friendly. They open at 11, so go buy one right after the show ends, or at some point today. Delicious and unique pies, great menu all the way around. Got to give a special thanks to Jason Roberts, Rick Gonzalez for working their tail off on this special. They've been watching the Ticket Live Big League West Special presented by Halftime Pizza.